the drilling works for the secant piling in SWRO plant has started. From this video, you can get a thorough knowledge about the drilling works of this secant piling. In this location, we are using the secant piling as a shoring arrangement for our intake pumping station. Now, we are marking the location of this pile using this auger. Now they are taking another attachment closer to the calibre. The name of this attachment is rock bucket. This rock bucket is used to remove the material inside the drill hole. Actually, in this area, the area is fully covered with sand, so we can use this rock bucket to remove the sand inside the drill hole. As you can see in the video, now we are taking casing adapter closer to the rig, which we need to fix it to the rotary drive. The piling rig we are using for this project is called DG28. It's a very powerful drilling machine. We can do drilling works very fast using this machine. The cylindrical attachment which you can see now in the video is called casing adapter. In future, the casings we are going to use to be attached to this adapter. Before attaching this adapter to the rotary drive, we have to remove the pin that is fixed to this rotary arm. For removing that pin, we need to remove this half circle part by removing that two Allen bolts. As you can see now, this worker is removing two Allen bolts and removing the half circle part. After removing the locking arrangement, now he has removed the pin. There are two pins in each side. After removing both the pins, this rig and rotary arm to be matched with the hole in the encasement arrangement. As you can see now, they are aligning the hole from the rotary arm and the hole in the adapter. After aligning the rotary arm and the adapter hole, now they have to insert the pin which they have removed earlier and fix it with the half circle lock and two Allen bolts. Now they have to take encasement and fix it to the adapter. We are using this casing as a shoring to the drill hole. This area is filled with sand, so there is a good chance to collapse the surrounding while boring operations are going on. That's why we are using this encasement. When describing sequence of this piling operation, first of all, we have to drive this encasement to a depth of 2 to 3 meters. And then the inside material can be removed using the rock bucket. After that, again we have to drive this encasement to another few meters, and again the material inside should be removed. Likewise, this cycle will go on until reaching the bottom. Now they are stabilizing the encasement and removing the hook. After using the hook for lifting, we have to secure it in this location to avoid any entanglements and accidents. In this video you can see that they have inserted the Kelly bar to the casing, and now they are going to fix the adapter to the casing. After fixing the casing to the adapter, the casing can be driven to the piling location. They have taken the encasement to the piling location. After taking the encasement and driving it about 1 or 2 meters, it is essential to check the alignment of the encasement, because for the secant piling it is very essential to ensure the vertical alignment of the pile. If it is not vertical, there can have problems during the main construction works. Therefore, we have to check the verticality of the pile using spirit level in 2 perpendicular directions. As you can see now, this pile is almost vertical. If required, we have to adjust the alignment of the mast of the rig to maintain the verticality of the pile. Now they are inserting this encasement into the piling location and driving at least 2 to 3 meters inside before removing the material in the core. Again, the alignment is being checked to ensure the verticality of this encasement. After inserting the encasement about 2 to 3 meters, now the rock bucket is being fixed to the Kelly bar. As I have explained before, this rock bucket is inserting inside the encasement to remove the soil inside the encasement. As you can see, after inserting the rock bucket inside the encasement, the Kelly bar is rotating and lowering to collect whatever the material inside the encasement. After collecting the material into the rock bucket, the material can be removed from the core of the casing onto outside. As you can see in the video, now they are removing the material inside the rock bucket. In the mechanism of the rock bucket, as you can see in this video, there is one lever arrangement attached to it. If you pull this lever, the bottom part of the rock bucket will be open and the material inside will be unloaded to the outside. As you can see in this video, now this worker is pulling the lever and unleashing the bottom part of this rock bucket. After opening the bottom part of this rock bucket, the rig itself can lock it back by pushing the bottom openable part to the ground. As you can see now, the first sleeve encasement is all the way driven to the ground, and now they are going to fix the second encasement to the top of the first encasement. first the coupling area to be cleaned and applied with grease. The casing are fixed together with 12 Allen bolts which are fully embedded in the encasement to avoid unnecessary entanglements. Now the second encasement is placed on top of the first encasement. Now they are going to insert the bolts, as you can see. They are inserting the bolts through the holes between the first encasement and second encasement. After putting the bolts to be tightened thoroughly. Now in this video, you can see the core bucket. When there is a location when they can't excavate with the rock bucket, they are going to use the core bucket and loosen the soil inside, and then the soil will be removed by the rock bucket. Now they are going to insert the second encasement to the ground. Actually the sequence of the piling will be the same. First they are going to insert the encasement to the ground about 2 to 3 meters, and they are going to remove the inside material using rock bucket or core bucket. It will continue up to the depth whatever they require to go for the piling. This attachment is called the finishing bucket. This one is using to remove the last loose material inside the piling hole. And here also they have the same attachment as the rock bucket. There is one lever, so you can pull the lever and the bottom part of the bucket can be removed to remove the material inside. Thank you very much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed the video. Subscribe for more.